During the tensest periods of the Cold War, the entire globe watched as two superpowers clashed across numerous domains. Yet it was the cosmos that became the grand arena for flaunting technological supremacy. Imagine the scene. The USSR succeeded in launching the very first man-made satellite into orbit around Earth, setting a monumental benchmark. How did the USA respond? They escalated the stakes by sending the first human to the lunar surface. Now let's ponder this. What does it truly mean to be first in space? Fast forward past the Cold War, with the Soviet Union no longer in the picture, the United States has taken giant leaps in the race to explore the cosmos. Consider this. NASA, the leading space agency, boasts an impressive annual budget of $32 billion. That's an amount that no other space agency on the planet can match. But here's a thought. Does having the most money translate to being the most innovative? Now let's shift our gaze to a new horizon. There's a challenger in the realm of space exploration, rewriting the playbook: China. What's remarkable is how rapidly China is closing the gap with the US, even outpacing it in certain aspects. Have you ever wondered what drives a nation to reach for the stars? Join me in this journey at Space Basics, where we unravel the feats of a country that just a half century ago was merely an observer in the space race. Amidst internal upheaval and the Cultural Revolution, China managed to launch its first satellite in 1970. And to provide some context, back then, NASA was already deep into the development of the Voyager missions, set to launch merely 7 years later. So how does a country go from a standing start to full throttle in space innovation? Could it be ambition, resilience, or sheer necessity? What do you think motivates a nation to make such quantum leaps in space technology? As we delve into this odyssey, let's ask ourselves, what does the future hold for space exploration? And in this vast universe, what new mysteries will we uncover next? Stay tuned as we embark on this stellar exploration together. Since those early days, the landscape of space exploration has undergone a seismic shift. Did you know that in the last decade, China has propelled over 200 rockets into the cosmos? That's not just a number, it's a testament to their burgeoning presence in the space sector. They've not only touched the moon with their unmanned missions, but have also established their own orbiting habitat, the Tiangong Space Station. This move came after the exclusion from the International Space Station. Have you ever stopped to wonder what it takes to build such an ambitious program? The figures are staggering. State media in China suggests that around 300,000 individuals have contributed to their space endeavors. That's a workforce nearly 18 times larger than NASA's. Now, that begs the question, does a larger team guarantee success, or does the innovation of a few lead to breakthroughs? The current space race narrative is taking a fascinating twist with China's bold aspirations. They're not just competing, they're innovating, with plans to take on the James Webb Space Telescope's deep space observations. But they're doing it with an armada of microsatellites, each equipped with its own compact X-ray telescope. Imagine 100 eyes peering into the universe's most mysterious, energetic, and transient phenomena. It's a stark contrast to the convention of building larger telescopes. Have you considered what this means for the future of space observation? This ambitious project, known as the CATCH or the Constellation Hunters, aims to deploy hundreds of these satellites to form a network. It's not just about having a large number of satellites, but also creating a symphony of instruments working in harmony to capture the ephemeral events of the cosmos. What will they find with this innovative approach? What secrets of the universe might we uncover with these transient hunters in the sky? As we continue our exploration into the strides made by nations in the cosmic arena, one can't help but ponder the possibilities these advancements bring. Amidst this riveting era of space exploration, China has made headlines yet again, this time achieving a feat that many were closely watching. Have you ever wondered what it takes to not just compete, but actually lead in the space race? Let's dive into this recent triumph. The Chinese aerospace company Landspace has successfully reached orbit with its Zhuge 2 ZQ-2 rocket. This launch, conducted from the Jiuquan Satellite Launch Center situated in the vast expanse of the Gobi Desert, was not just another entry into the logbooks. US Space Force tracking data verified the Chinese reports, confirming that the methane-powered ZQ-2 reached its intended orbit. It's a significant leap, especially considering the rocket's initial flight faced challenges back in December 2022. Methane as a rocket fuel isn't just about the visually appealing blue flame it produces upon ignition. Its advocates tout its environmental edge, being cleaner than the traditional RP1 or kerosene that powers many rockets. Methane, while a greenhouse gas, is gaining momentum for its potential in spaceflight. And did you know that it can be synthesized on Mars, making it a key player in visions for interplanetary travel? It's not only China that's venturing into methane rocket technology. Numerous US companies are hot on the trail. From SpaceX with its ambitious Starship system to Blue Origin's New Glenn and several others in the lineup, the race is on. Yet it's not without its hiccups. For instance, Relativity Space's Terran 1 and SpaceX's Starship have encountered setbacks in their initial launches. Despite these challenges, China's pace in space is unrelenting. In 2022, they achieved an impressive tally of 54 missions to orbit and aim to surpass that with over 60 planned launches in 2023. How does this compare on the global stage? SpaceX, the most prolific US launcher, had 61 launches in 2022. This surge in launches is not just about quantity, it's a reflection of China's growing clout in the cosmic realm. As we witness these advancements, we can't help but marvel at the progress and ponder the implications. What does this mean for international collaboration and competition in space? How will these efforts shape the future of global space exploration? I'm curious to hear your thoughts. What's your take on this recent development? Drop your comments below and join the conversation. And remember, if you're hungry for more space insights, subscribe to Space Basics. Together, let's keep reaching for the stars. Until our next cosmic update, keep looking up.